And then when we're done getting the rights, they go back to work, you know? And so you can see the problem that we have. And now the new problem is that Africa must unite. Somehow South Africans, they're not voting Julius Malema because they're not wanting to unite. They like the white man. Excuse me. There are other 53 countries. There's no way that the entire continent is not able to unite just because South Africa is not coming to the party. So that notion, it needs to be scrapped and challenged. And I am challenging it because I want somebody who can come through this life and convince me, why is South Africa the pivotal country to go and unite Africa? What is the, are you telling me other 53 countries are not capable of doing that? Because that can't be. That can't be. We cannot then be held in ransom and be made to feel guilty for not wanting to the party of unity. And the other false narrative is that Africa is united. If you're going to use an example of doing business, there's no continent that is has easier movement of doing business than Africa. We are third in compared to Europe and China. We are the third or the fourth when you count the Europe, you count China, you count America. We're the third people, we're the third continent that is able, out of seven continents, we are able to do business with each other here. There is no hindrance whatsoever. So when people come and talk lies and say we are not united and we need to be united so that business, there's no business person or woman or businessman who can tell you, no, I'm not able to do business with Kenya. We have a treaty that was signed by 48 countries in this year. It's an African trade union treaty that was signed by 48 countries out of 52. 85% of Africa is able to trade freely with each other. So this unity that you guys are talking about, this African unity, you're talking about this Julius Malema who has no interest for South Africa that you're talking about, he's neither here nor there. The only thing that is that I'm seeing that people are saying and doing here is people who are rejecting their responsibility and they delegating their responsibilities to other people. You have Zimbabweans who come here and run away from there and leave Abogogo that side and come here and live comfortable life here. And when they get here, they do all the shenanigans that we don't accept. And in terms of that, we go to and want to have, we go to and take responsibility and take our government into account. We take people that we work for into account, into we make them to account, and we will hold them into account and make sure which we have our rights adhered to. Even when we work at the restaurant or garage or at the bank, we hold all these people into account. But only foreigners will come and accept every nonsense so that they can just get 50 rand and go home. And South Africans are not tuned like that. And so it becomes a problem then.
Do you really believe the crap you're talking now?
Yes, I am. Yes, I do. I do believe it. Yes, I do believe it.
Because you're talking a lot of shit now.
My brother, you just come to the platform and just come and say that. Why can't you greet us? Why can't you wait and listen? What are we talking about?
Because he's talking a lot of shit now. And I was on the live a long time.
What are we talking about?
About the EFF coming to save the country and everything. The EFF is not going to save anything.
Did he say EFF is going to save the country?
Yes, he said it.
Were you listening?
Why are we not voting for the EFF? Because the African countries is
nobody wants to
do business with South Africa or something like that.
Were you listening on to what you were saying?
Fuck off, man.
All right, sharp. No problem.
All right. So at the end of the day, I think more than we have to preach the unity of Africa, which is good, which is needed, which is something that we want in future, it's fine. But at the end of the day, as people, I think as Africans, we need to teach each other bravery first. And once we can teach each other bravery, it will be easy for us to unite. Because if you think about the bravery that is happening in Niger right now, in Burkina Faso, you look at Kenya, you look at South Africa, those people are people of Africa that are leading the conversation of bravery. Because in the world, in this global in this global stage, if you do not have balls, you're not going to achieve anything in the economy. You can be united all you want, but if your mentality is that of Zimbabweans, of running away, of talking about being great and being educated, but you're not doing anything, you're not achieving anything. You're not achieving anything. That conversation is useless, because can you imagine if we are 52 countries, we are united, but every time when we have to vote for an agreement, some people, they're scared of white people, some people are scared to offend, some people are all of this. Yeah.
Let me ask you this. As good as we are as South Africans, or as loaded as we are and as developed as we are, do we need other countries?
Absolutely not.
All right, so we don't need that.
Not more than we need them at an equal level, in a trade level. That is as far as we can need each other.
That's what I'm saying. Do we need them to assist us, or do they need us, or are we good alone? Are we powerful alone, independently? Can we survive without these guys?
We have survived for many years without them, and don't take them with this.
If we were to be landlocked, we decide we are no longer going to their countries. When we come out, we are going to Europe and come back. We are going to Middle East and come back. Would we do better as a country?
Absolutely.
So you believe we don't need these guys?
We don't. No, there's no proof anyway in the past 100 years that shows that South Africa is dependent on anybody else. You can break South Africa as an island right now and keep us just like Madagascar. We can still survive. We've proven that we are able to survive without anybody else. And if by surviving, I don't mean that we say we're not going to go trade with other parties. We're not going to trade with other countries. We can trade with China. We can trade with Russia, America, and South America, and all of those kind of guys easily. And in fact, many other countries, they do not know how to trade with the outside world of Africa unless they come to South African ports for them to help out. If you look at South African Reserve Bank, is actually the biggest organization that helps Africa to trade because of the port system that we have and the border system that we have. So if South Africa were to break away from Africa, to be honest, a whole lot of countries will suffer, especially the countries that are inland that do not have ports, because that system of trade happens easily when are under customs. And who has the best customs system? It is South Africa. So I don't think we need anybody that much, especially in Africa. Most African countries, they need us more than we need them.
No problem. Take two.
Hello.
Take two, I'll give
hello,
you.
Hello.
Take two, don't worry, I'll give you. Let me ask the brother a few last questions. So, my brother, I hear you. You are saying we do not need Africa. We do not need Africa. So do we need Abezungu? You saw one Zungu came just now and told me, you saw what he did. I don't have to tell you what he has done. So do we need Abezungu in South Africa? Between our African brothers and Abezungu, who would you prefer?
If currently we don't need Abezungu, right? None whatsoever. We don't need them. Especially with the emergence of China, India and South America. In the past, we needed them because obviously it was difficult to trade globally as black people without having a white face. So for putting them in the front in terms of allowing the other world, because you know those people are very united. If you break law, if you're working against one of them in your own country, they can make your life very difficult. We've seen that in many other countries. But now with the new emergence of new economies like the China economy, the Russia, the South America, and the India, now they don't have a choice. I mean, even the conversations of having, let's say, for an example, de-dollarization, that conversation is only happening because new economies have emerged. And so in this current in this current moment, they are null and void, so useless. We don't need them. They can leave for Australia, all of them, 10% of them tomorrow. We will actually survive far much better. As for replacing them with the African brothers, no. African brothers, we don't need them at all. Both them and Abazungu, we don't need either this or either of these parties. South Africa as a whole, as we are, we can survive easily. You know, if you look at many, like Madagascar, for an example, Madagascar is surviving very well and they don't need anybody. They don't have Abazungu, they don't have African people, and yet they are part of us. And so you can see, Witi, it's easy to survive without these people. And there are many other examples I can give you of countries where there are no Abazungu, there are no African brothers, and it's just those natives that are in that country and they are surviving very well. So this notion of needing each other, blah, 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 no, it's not there. We are able to trade globally with everybody. And that's the power that we have. And right now, whether you take Abazungu out, there's no country. China is not going to stop trading with you because there's suddenly no a white man here. That's not going to happen.
All right, Sharp. Take two, how are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm good. How are things?
No, it's all good. I'm loving the statements that my brother here is saying. They are quite amazing.
Oh, all right. No, understand. So, do you think South Africans were right not to vote for EFF? And okay, who is the future? Or who do you think, if you were South African, who do you think is the future? Where did you go, my brother? Where did you go? Who do you think is the future between all these political parties in South Africa? Do you blame South Africans for not voting EFF? And do you think we need you guys?
I think you have answered you a long time ago, and you know my answers and my view. But for the sake of the platform, I'll re-answer you again. Africa needs Africans, and Africa, we need each other as Africans. So as long as you are black and you are African, we need each other. This tribal, or I am South Africa, I am Zimbabwe, I am Malawi, I am Madagascar, I am what? Hey. Yeah, it pains me a lot because we're still speaking the very old statements that our forefathers spoke of. And up to now, I worry if we are ever going to go to the future. My brother has a view that I respect a lot, ne? And his view is very correct. He wants to lock down the country. Nobody must come in. But now there's a gray area in his statement where he says, we will trade with the Chinese, we will trade with them. So eventually, he's still opening it up. I wish if he says he wants to lock it down, he must lock down everything so that it becomes independent of its own, and it will grow, and I support his statement. To answer your question, what was the question?
Do you blame South Africans for not voting for EFF?
Well, the concept of voting is under constitution. Constitution governs. Regardless of who is who, ANC, DA, I really don't pick. We're still talking about foxes, swapping foxes for hyenas. Until we change the laws to the African. So when my brother says he wants to lock down the country, which is fine, dissolve all the political parties and take your indigenous African customary law. My brother, I will support your statement. But now, because this might be a may belief, and this is a fantasy talk, you will find that none of these things is going to happen anytime soon until all the political parties dissolve the Roman Dutch law. If you don't dissolve the Roman Dutch law, whoever you decide to vote for, it's still the same thing. They're just gonna practice the fencing thing that the old apartheid used to practice, only on a different platform of black face, colored face, Indian face. I don't care. If we are independent as Africans, we need to be independent even in our laws. But if we are not independent in our law, there is no country in Africa that is independent at all. We are still under colonial. And his point is proving how colonial we are, because he still wants to trade with him. I'm not insulting him. I'm just saying, as a Zimbabwean, it's also disappointing on my part, because I'm also suffering the very same consequences that if we lock down Zimbabwe, South Africa won't be able to travel to any country. But he doesn't want to travel or move anywhere, which is fine. When we lock down Zimbabwe, which means there is no movement of anyone crossing through Zimbabwe to Zambia, DRC, or other areas, and all if Mozambique closes, they won't be able to go anywhere, and when all the other countries closes, they won't be able to move nowhere.
That
which is fine.
Take two.
But what laws
take
is?
Take two. The South Africans need to go to DRC. The South Africans need to go anywhere.
Yes.
Whether you lock Zimbabwe or not, do South Africans want to travel? Do you think you want to go to DRC? You want to go to Congo? Do you think you want to go there?
Right now, I'm calculating 32 that I know so far that are busy doing business in DRC, moving up and down. 32 that I've counted so far. Then I even come into Zimbabwe platform.
Can I answer you, take
DRC,
two?
I even never know that.
Still wait. Allow him to finish. We'll give you a chance. Take two and listen.
A colored guy who married a Zambian with a beard.